Hi, Doug Stuman with IT Creations with the Tyan Transport B8050F65TV8E2H-N server tower. This system is based off the FT65TB8050 chassis, and there's two other models that are remarkably similar. In a nutshell, they all support 4th generation AMD EPYC CPUs, codenamed Genoa, DDR5 memory modules, and PCIe 5.0. Hit that subscribe button if you like our reviews. And now, back to our regularly scheduled programming. Is it a workstation or is it a server? This would be more of a networked, high-performance computing server that can be used for workstation support. That said, there is some potential for a standalone workstation. It can be used as a tower in an office setting or rack-mounted with a rail kit to install in a server enclosure. Supported on this platform are not only the standard 4th generation AMD EPYC Genoa CPUs, but also the fairly new Genoa X and Bergamo CPUs. Those last are still regarded as 4th generation AMD EPYC CPUs. As a refresher, the Genoa X, which are the 9004 series processors, have an X on the end and still top out at 96 cores but have a higher L3 cache at up to 1152 megabytes compared to the standard Genoa CPUs at up to 384 megabytes of L3 cache. To be clear, there is only one Genoa X CPU that does support 1152 megabytes of L3 cache, and that would be the 9684X CPU. That one boasts 96 cores, 192 virtual threads, a base frequency of 2550 megahertz, boosting to 3700 megahertz, and a TDP of 400 watts. It fits the same SP5 socket as standard Genoa CPUs. Those with 3D V-cache technology are used for highly technical applications that benefit from a higher data queuing at the CPU, like fluid dynamics, databases, electronic design automation, and structural analysis, to name a few. Also great for fast rendering and AEC applications, I'm quite sure. These CPUs represent the second generation of AMD's EPYC 3D V-cache technology, first introduced during the Milan or third generation era. But with significantly more cache at 1152 megabytes compared to 768 megabytes on the first generation. Are you interested in the Tyan Transport B8050F... this thing? Server tower? If you are, then for a limited time, you can save up to $500 off the cost of a system listed on our site or one that you can configure that's listed at $5,000 or more. Just click that link to visit IT Creations and see more information on the system. Once you're ready to make a purchase, just mention this video. IT Creations can also custom configure that system to your specifications. Think about it. Ciao. Ah, Bergamo. Just northeast of Milan and boasting a population of over 200,000. This city is perhaps a little less known than, say, Naples, Rome, Milan, or Genoa. Bergamo. Still fits in nicely with AMD's journey through Italy. The processor, on the other hand, new as of June 13, 2023, is designed for cloud-native computing. Cloud-native, in a nutshell, just means a software approach to building, deploying, and managing applications in the cloud. Theoretically, no time-consuming hardware provisioning, and no hard questions on future upgrades and whatnot. It takes the emphasis off the hardware side, supposedly. And I say supposedly because what are we looking at right now? The hardware, CPUs, an actual server. Anyways, these have a product SKU also in the 9004 series range and support for up to 128 cores instead of up to 96 cores like standard Genoa. Sienna, on the other AMD EPYC variant that was just released, is not supported. Those would be the 8004 series processors you may have heard about. We'll leave that for another time, but I will add those are for telco and intelligent edge computing, specifically. Bergamo, and I had to look up the pronunciation of that, features less cache than standard Genoa to make room for more cores. They're denoted by 97X4 because there are only three CPUs in this family, just like Genoa X. The chiplet architecture is different too, with Zen 4C instead of Zen 4 cores. Also, instead of 12 8-core CCDs, which I will call chiplets for simplicity's sake, there are 8 16-core chiplets. All of that too creates more cores and up to 256 virtual threads on one of those CPUs. Another in the same Bergamo family, the 9754S, has just single-threaded cores, so 128 physical cores and 128 virtual threads. Probably what that S suffix on the end means. I'll have 256 megabytes of L3 cache. Keep in mind these are different than the 3D V-cache CPUs or Genoa X. Up front there are 8 3.5-inch storage bays with 2 more 2.5-inch storage bays above. Those 2.5-inch bays can be outfitted with SATA, SAS, or NVMe U.2 hot swap drives. If you do install SAS drives, you will need a discrete SAS HD RAID controller. Those 3.5-inch drives below support SAS and SATA with a backplane that connects to onboard SATA connections by default. Here also, SAS is supported with a discrete SAS HBA RAID controller. That control panel at the top of the chassis has the power on button, a few telltale lights for LANs 3, 2, and 1, corresponding to the RJ45 ports on the back of the system. Below those, more LEDs for the Integrated Platform Management Interface, or IPMI, hard drives, and that last one, an ID LED if this system is rack-mounted at some point. Next to those, a reset button, non-maskable interrupt, and ID button, then two USB 3.1 ports. There is an optical drive bay blank right below that where an optical drive can be installed. I mean, aside from mentioning reserved space for 2.5-inch HDD trays for that media bay, there is not really any information available on a possible storage kit for that area. The back of the system has an ID button, so you can activate that ID LED on the front panel. A dedicated RJ45 port for management of the system, LAN 3, and two USB 3.1 ports below that. Next to those, a VGA port on top and COM port below. The two stacked RJ45 ports are LAN 2 on top and LAN 1 below, both 1 gigabit Ethernet. Then there's a single fixed power supply on top, either a 1500 watt or 2000 watt ATX platinum or gold respectively. On the lower portion, there's a block of dual fans to help vent the system of the GPU scented hot air. Although with that auxiliary fan bracket, it does cover the PCIe access slots for potential display ports where you might connect monitors. But not really surprising, this is presented as a pedestal server, not a workstation. With that dedicated management port on the back of the system, this platform can be managed remotely. It has a 1 gigabit Ethernet interface and connects to the ASSPEED AST2600 baseboard management controller. IPMI 2.0 compliant, it supports storage over IP and remote platform flash. Tyan offers TSM Plus 2.0, or Tyan Server Management Plus 2.0, software to manage the system. This is the next generation of Tyan server management software for remote access, monitoring, and management either in-band or out-of-band. It supports Tyan servers that support Intel Xeon Scalable and AMD EPYCs from the third generation on. Supported on most browsers, it delivers an intuitive web-based user interface and can help manage one-to-many servers. You also get server discovery, asset tracking, alerts, firmware updates, event logs, and it can manage several servers simultaneously. There is a free version that you can trial for 30 days for up to 3 servers, and a paid version. With a 30-day trial, it seems like you can get a real feel for the management software using the free version before committing to a paid version. Inside the chassis, there's a row of 3 large fans which are consistent with all 3 configurations of the system. The lower portion has the 8 3.5-inch drive bays with SAS SATA backplane and 2 slim SAS connectors for connecting 4 drives each. Above that, the 2 2.5-inch drive bays with a small SAS SATA NVMe backplane with dual SATA cable connectors and a single slim SAS cable connector. On the other side of the fans, you can see the motherboard with a single socket supporting a CPU with a configurable TDP of 320 watts. However, conditional support for other CPUs is mentioned. That conditional support might entail high-performance heatsink or perhaps liquid cooling. Included in the CPU list for this system is the 9684X, that Genoa X CPU with a 400-watt TDP and 3D V-cache at 1,152 megabytes. That would be the top of the stack for the TDP, so you can safely assume, contingencies met, this system will support the full range of 4th generation AMD EPYC CPUs, Genoa, Genoa X, and those with 3D V-cache. The back of the system is really the defining characteristic to the 3 variants of the system. Our system today, with a dash N on the name, has 2 1 gigabit Ethernet ports and an auxiliary set of 2 fans barnacled on the back. Next, the chassis with a dash T dash N on the back has only those 2 1 gigabit Ethernet ports, but also 2 10 gigabit Ethernet ports, again with the 2 auxiliary fans. Lastly, the one with the dash G, that one has 2 1 gigabit Ethernet ports and only the 3 internal fans, just like the other 2 chassis. That's it. If you need passively cooled GPUs, you should consider getting the dash 2T-N or the dash N chassis like we have here. That dash G server tower only takes the RTX A6000 GPUs, which feature active cooling. That said, it would be a candidate potentially for turning into a standalone workstation tower, as the display ports would be accessible from the back of the chassis. The other 2, I suppose you could leave off the additional dual fan bracket attached to the back of the system, but what's the fun in that? Those other 2 chassis, the dash N and the dash 2T-N, are designed to support passively cooled GPUs, including the NVIDIA H100 with 4th generation Tensor cores and 80 gigabytes of memory. You know, that top-of-the-line Hopper architecture-based GPU that's ideal for AI, AI and inference, plus machine learning and deep learning? This GPU does not support DirectX 11 or 12, so not a gaming GPU, but still 80 gigabytes of HBM2E memory. Also, 14,592 shading units, 456 texture mapping units, and 24 ropes. What are ropes? That is raster operations pipeline that handles color compression and anti-aliasing. This card has a 16-pin power connector and a power draw of up to 350 watts, maximum. The PSU on this system is set up for a 16-pin power connector specifically to support those two GPUs. The card features a PCIe 5.0x16 interface. Fortunately, that is indeed what we have on this system with five full-height, full-length PCIe 5.0x16 slots. This system is set up to support not one, but two of those high-performance graphics cards. There are no display ports on the H100, as this card is meant to support use as a network server. One of the interesting features of the H100 is that it can be partitioned into seven instances, also known as MIG, for multi-instance GPU. Those instances can be secured, encrypted, and distributed to individual virtual workstations, along with a few CPU cores and some of that 2 terabytes of memory. This GPU also supports NVLink for greater performance potential of a single GPU instance when two installed GPUs are sharing resources. With the Tyan Transport B8050F65TV8E2H-N server tower, you have options for outfitting the system to meet your needs as either a standalone tower or something you can rack mount in an enclosure. As your business grows, perhaps it transitions from a front office tower server to a growing network of servers. With a single AMD EPYC processor, there are plenty of cores to work with that can be augmented by NVIDIA's top-of-the-line GPU accelerators, plus up to 2 terabytes of memory and flexible storage options. If you liked our video, hit that subscribe button. Looking for actual hardware? Then visit IT Creations. Chances are we have what you need. We're partners with Tyan and offer new and legacy hardware. Give it a try and look around. I placed a few links for more information in the description below and right there. Till next time, I'm Doug Stuman with IT Creations. Thanks for watching.